My name is Chelsea Gustafson, and I'm a graduate student, a third-year graduate student at the University of California, Santa Cruz. And I'm in the Partch Lab, where we study circadian rhythms. Circadian rhythms are the body's way of coordinating physiological processes with the solar day. So they happen in a variety of organisms, all the way from humans down to algae. And the processes at the molecular level are a little different for those different organisms.
I grew up in Rogue River, Oregon, and then when I was in middle school, we moved to Medford, Oregon.
My father is a scientist, and my mother is a healthcare practitioner. And so I got a lot of science at home. And they were amazing in that they didn't push it on either me or my brother. But when you're in one of those fields, you're engaged and interested, hopefully, as they were, in what you're doing. And so there was a lot of talk, and I could see that they loved what they did. And so that definitely affected me.
I've always been curious about biological processes and how the world works and how our bodies work. And I get to couple, every day I get to come into work and I get to couple the detail-oriented science of chemistry with biological processes. And that's really fun.
So how the circadian system works, at least in humans, is we get an input of light at 480 nanometers, so that's blue light. It comes into our retina and there are photosensing cells in our retina that are distinct and different than our visual cells. Okay, so they see the light, and it gets processed through your neuronal network into this organ called the suprachiasmatic nucleus. And the SCN then is what we call the central clock, or the master clock. And so it will oscillate, right, depending on the input of the light. And then what the SCN does is it couples to the endocrine system. And the endocrine system can then regulate the temperature of your body and also a variety of different hormones, such as melatonin is one that people commonly have heard of, in order to tell the rest of your body what time it is. Our society is so full of devices that keep us up late at night. We have artificial lights, so we can stay up late, and they found is people who work swing shifts or shifts that are against their circadian rhythm, so say they sleep in the daytime and they're awake at night, have a higher incidence of obesity, diabetes, early death, cardiovascular disease, depression, a variety of physiological responses, because we're doing things at times that we shouldn't be doing them, and that's hard on the body.
And so I think being able to get this research out and allowing people to understand and then make decisions based upon this information, I think just in and of itself, having that information is important for people. I think maybe the biggest piece of advice is to not get discouraged. A lot of people are going to struggle with step one, and it's not a reflection of how good of a scientist you are. It's actually a reflection of how good of a scientist you are if you keep doing it, because what science requires is tenacity.
Thank you.